Kia ora te whānau, welcome back. Is time up for Sir Tim Shadbolt? New Zealand's longest running mayor has been under pressure this term over concerns he's no longer fit to lead Invercargill. Whena Owen went to meet the wide range of challenges, hoping to take his place.
On arrival in Invercargill this week, yet another council squabble was playing out.
You have milk?
Milk and one sugar, please.
The mayor, Sir Tim Shadbolt, slamming his deputy for the decision not to fund a rental car to get him from Wellington to the local government conference in Palmerston North.
Why do you think that they've said you can't have a rental car?
I just think it's pure jealousy. All the people who have opposed me in these forthcoming elections are running for the mayoralty.
Nobby, what's your real name?
Oh, my real name is William Stewart.
William? Okay, yeah. Well, I might stick with Nobby.
You will stick with Nobby,
yeah, stick
because
with
everybody
Nobby.
Knows me as Nobby.
Anyone knows?
Deputy Mayor Nobby Clark is standing against New Zealand's longest-serving mayor.
What's your relationship like with Tim Shadbolt?
It's terrible. Yeah, it really is. Very, very hard to work with His Worship, and more in particular, work with his partner, who drives a lot of the issues. So I've tried and tried and tried. I mean, I love the man personally. I think he's done great things for the city, and he's been very good to me when I've had a fatality in my family. But it's time for him to go.
Nobby Clark is running on the ticket Let's Go Invercargill, with eight others so far.
These people are all independents. When they, I mean, you're on council, I don't have any control over them. Not at all.
We're in the city's brand new hotel, weeks away from opening. It's community owned via a licensing trust and part of the rejuvenation of the inner city, including a new mall, partly funded by the council.
We're on the cusp of something amazing here. We just need some really strong leadership.
Cherie Carey is the head of Invercargill's Chamber of Commerce.
Invercargill's doing great. The region as a whole is doing amazing. So 5.4% increase in GDP in the last quarter, which is higher than national average, higher than pre-COVID levels.
But the council itself has had a rocky ride, the Department of Internal Affairs stepping in to investigate.
Once we went through that internal review process, and realised how we needed to behave with each other, things have been fine, with one exception.
Mayoral candidate Darren Ludlow is getting over COVID.
But he said he's okay to talk to us. Hi, Darren. How are you doing?
He's been on council since 1998.
Having an understanding of what's gone on before isn't necessarily essential, but it's a hell of a help.
And you're saying you have that?
Oh, gosh, yes.
Tim's done his dash, he's done well for the city, but I think it is time for a change, but I'm not sure who.
Well, he'll have plenty of contenders to choose from. In this city, it's more a case of who's not running for mayor.
This is Rhea Bond, ex-New Zealand First, and guess what?
Well, Whena, I'm actually going to put my hand up and run in the local body election for mayor of Invercargill City.
We've got so many great projects going on and in the framework of going forward that I really want to be part of that.
Will you vote for Tim again? He's put Invercargill on the map.
He has, but his days might be over, I think.
I'll just kiss the baby. That's what us politicians are here to do.
After 28 years as mayor, we wanted to know why Sir Tim still wants the job.
What would you say to the people who say, why don't you just retire now, you know?
Yes, that is an argument, but there's another petty... Well, it's not petty this time. Councillors who have missed out are determined now to take me to court for the defamation case. And again, it doesn't look like it's much, you know, it's only 180,000, but it's a lot when you're just a student coming off and running in a sort of creative level of being a sort of creative type.
Mayor Tim's court disputes and his potential legal bills are well known. Other mayoral candidates' campaign spiels are more traditional. Councillor Rebecca Munson.
Apart from being young and energetic and hardworking, I have the skills to lead the change that our city is going through at the moment.
Another councillor, Ian Pottinger, known locally as Rangi, also wants to be mayor.
The old saying is, if you want something done right, you do it yourself.
I can honestly say without a shadow of a doubt, this place is, how can I say, it's awesome.
I think it's going off, really.
Invercargill.
Yeah.
Downtown, the people of Invercargill are admiring the first wing of their brand new mall. And we're also talking mayors.
I think we all need a celebrity to step up and take over. Like
another celebrity?
Well, we know Tim. We know and people vote for Tim. And if you haven't got a good character to take over, who's...
Why do you need a celebrity, though? What, don't you need someone who can just do the job well?
Oh, definitely do the job, but you know, they have to be sort of... It's a popularity thing as well.
0800 80 1080. Yeah, Jay Marcus, welcome. Thanks for calling. Good evening.
Marcus Lush, talkback host and first-term city councillor, politely declined to tell Q&A whether he was after the top job. The candidates are watching that space carefully.
Well, the potential is like he bolted in the by-election, and if he stood again, there could be that same support. Yet, sometimes when it gets to the top job, though, I think people probably take their time.
The man in the top job has watched his majority slip every election.
So that's a concern for you?
No, it's democracy, you know, and you go up and down. It's a real roller coaster ride, and that's why I enjoy it so much.
Unlike some other councils, Invercargill's water infrastructure is in very good nick. The council also has a good credit rating.
The CEO and the executive team they've got in there now, it's absolutely incredible. So it's a really high functioning council.
So does it need a new mayor?
Well, I think our leadership at the moment is coming from that leadership team and that CEO. They've been
not the mayor.
No, there's been workarounds the mayor, in my opinion.
The next mayor of Invercargill will be at the helm of a city reinventing itself. But with the rebuild and initiatives like green hydrogen on the horizon, there's just one problem.
You know, we've got some big industry down here, but we just need people. We need everyone to shift to Invercargill. We have a mall now.
Sounds good to me. Whena Owen with that report.